judge soon. Rule that those claims are credible, and consumers had a right to file suit for compensation. This power also ruled that those claims should be filed in the process for arbitration. Now that's good news for these companies, because while we can't guarantee outcomes, and every case is different, on average, consumers in arbitration recover hundreds of times more than in a class action. But in an arbitration, each consumer has to file their claim individually. That means if you're a PC gamer and you don't file your claim before the statute of limitations expires, you could lose out on your right to compensation. At Bookerlet, we've created a process that allows you to find out if you qualify in less time than it's taking you to watch this episode. Click the link, find out if you're eligible, and let's get started on this.
Get ready for Sal Vulcano, live, one hilarious night of stand-up comedy.
It's my first time paralyzing anyone. I'm going balls to the wall, okay? I do everything I do to the best of my ability. If I'm not to be paralyzing you,
Sal Vulcano, live, coming to a city near you. Tickets available Friday at 10 a.m.
They throw up figures who would otherwise have lain dormant. do the social strata. One of the great tragedies of capitalism is that as it overwhelms all of life, destroys initiative, destroys the capacity for human initiative, for human action to actually affect change. Capitalism and technology literally strips at every level of our autonomy, that means the top two. The few lords of Europe do not want capitalism to emerge. They see it as to need resources, power in the closed subject matter, the closed realm, the closed order, the Westphalian order of European states. Ability to affect the world around us. Now, we don't accept that fully, that's what ideology is going for, that's what our superstructure is for. The culture we live in inverts all values and takes all the values and gives us an explanation for why we have less power, why we're not able to do what our forebears are. Why we're terribly healing. And they had some explanations that they carried with them. Dimming of one's connection, and eventually you will become overtly aware of the connection. Then you are defeated. Then you are made into a slave. And it destroys your will. Belief in the system is sufficient for you to motivate yourself morally and intellectually and energetically. You are not able to fix yourself with investing in time. And you are literally disenchanted. That is where we find ourselves, where everyone at every level is stripped of autonomy. But these jobs still exist. We're still here. We're filling the same role with less belief in than ever, less self-motivation than ever. And that is American social fabric. Why people cannot do anything other than the most selfish thing. Because they are. Archetypes, relationships that have been forced upon by technology and time, capital, and religion. No, you can't go come up down too hard on them. That was a necessary response. Like, they provided necessary friction. I mean, it wasn't all great, obviously, but you can't blame it. It is a humane response to dehumanization. And yes, it turns into things like fascism and nationalism. It has to, and that heat has to go somewhere because capitalism is in control. But the tragedy of our age is that it is aromantic. There is no romance. There is no sense that you can affect anything, but there is no belief in anything but the self in its most narrow construction as an agent of economic inputs. Yummies and yuckies. That is what we have become. And now we're trying to make sense of a world where we are supposed to fulfill these social roles that had historically encoded with them rituals of affirmation of belief in a system, affirmation of belief in something that was worth